Well, dawn finds us at beautiful downtown Mellish Reef. This is spellbound, and in the background, if I can hold it still enough, you can see the reef.
Right, we're ready to go ashore.
Yeah,
this is the first trip ashore, and mark the way in with boys so we can run the yachts in. We'll see you shortly.
65
metre
visibility.
Is that right?
15 metres in the boat.
Can you see?
20 metres for the anchor chain.
Can you see Jeffrey's boat?
Yeah, see Jeff's boat underwater.
How far away is that?
60 odd metres.
Oh, amazing.
Just fabulous.
They're starting to bring gear up from down below on the spellbound, so we intend to head straight into the shore in the passage that's already been marked out, and take the gear straight off the bow, straight up the beach. Should be quite easy.
Here comes the hook now, Wood.
Now motoring in towards Mellish Reef. It's coming up 09:20 on Monday the 15th. After a week at sea, it's really great to get here. This is Jeff Toomey's yacht, just about to land now. Looks like the welcoming committee's there. Unloading is commencing on the spellbound. Looks like things are going according to plan. Unfortunately, we've had a major problem on the bark and bite. We had a bommy coming in, so we're at anchor, not far off the beach, maybe 100 yards, but we've got to sort out our propeller before we can come any further in. We have no engine power at the moment. We're just putting the dinghy over on the back and right to have a look at the damage down below on the prop shaft. It's Eric, K3NA, investigating the wildlife, just a step ashore. We haven't been ashore yet. Still trying to get our yacht organised with some motor power. Spellbound has completed discharging onto the beach and now heading down to the south end of the of Mellish. Not making much headway. Meaningful discussions going on about where we're putting things and what we do next. Okay, we finally made it with a little bit of help from Jeffrey from astern, and David towing from the front, and now we're unloading. Feels good to be ashore after a week at sea. First impressions of Mellish, looking towards the south. Well, there's quite a bit of green here, and the bird life certainly is very abundant. It's quite an incredible feeling to step ashore on a place quite as remote and desolate as Mellish Reef. Okay, well, we've started moving gear up the beach towards the northern end. Frank and Steve have got our first tent up, rather temporarily. It's only held on by four pegs. They were a bit concerned that we need to get some decent sand pegs, but we need nylon ties to hold the pegs to the tent because the actual holes in the tent floor aren't quite big enough to take a sand peg. A minor oversight. Having a look at the antenna site plan now to run out the cable from the tents so we can establish where exactly we can run the antennas. Right, the boys are just walking out the distance now to where the Battle Creek Special will be laid out. It's to the northern end of the reef. Right, we're now attempting to put the fly on. Not so easy in a breeze. Yeah, running out the cable. Yeah. Okay, it looks like Eric's got the SPDAs under control. Things are starting to come together here. Which antenna are you working on here?
15 meters driven element.
Things are starting to look a little bit more orderly now, with the first tent up and all the coax cable has been run out.
Just putting the generators together here.
Now we've got our fly tent established. Looks good.
Beautiful.
First pull. Excellent. Very, very quiet Honda. Now we're putting together the new equipment. This is the FT1000 field. Tatsu just putting that one together. We have the low frequency band equipment out in the fly with the Vectra V1000 linear amplifier and 51,000 NT. Right, here's the approved method for putting a tent peg into a very sandy beach. Dig a hole, put the rope around the tent peg and make a dead man anchor of it by burying it.
Is this going to be the final place of the...
Here we have all the bandpass filters, kindly brought over by Eric, made by W3NQN. All of the equipment was, all the important equipment which we didn't want to lose or get wet is packed in plastic containers like these, and the contents are listed on the cover of each box so that everything comes out of each box and goes back into the same box at the end of the trip. This is the antenna patch panel where all the filters will be assembled, and the antennas will come to this point. From this point, 10 meter fly leads will go to each radio, and each operator comes to this particular panel to select the antenna that they are going to operate on. They will also take with them a Velcro patch to put on the radio indicating what antenna that radio is connected to, so there can be no confusion about what band, what radio is operating at any one time. A lot of international coordination went into this. Steve, G3EDG, suggested the idea, which was adopted by the group. Eric, K3NA, came up with the filters. Peter, VK4APG, built the patch panel. And we've got a couple of the SPDA driven elements up at this stage. We've decided to put up the parasitic elements as a second phase of the antenna operation, so that we can at least be operational with a vertical only initially, since we're running sort of daylight. It's now 10 to 4, gets dark around 6 p.m. We want to have all bands operational by, I guess, dark. So we're not too far away from that.